Welcome you all to the 23rd webinar in the IEEE Malabar subsection and IEEE Malabar Hub Thursday webinar series. Today's webinar is on interactive presentation tools by Dr. Tiago. Dr. Tiago is assistant professor in the Department of Central University of Kerala, Kasaragod. He has a PhD from Bharathiyar University. And he has more than 15 years of experience in teaching. He has published 3 books and more than 79 papers in journals. He has also published more than 100 papers in different conferences, and he got a best paper award in 7 different conferences. So with this, I am inviting Dr. Tiago to the webinar on interactive presentation tools. So before handing over to sir, I have some instructions to the participants. Please disable your audio and video in order to save the data and for smooth conduct of the program. Only speakers' audio will be enabled for lecturing. Any queries can be informed through chat window, and this will be discussed at the end of the session. Over to you, sir.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you. So I welcome you once again, all the participants. The task is assigned for me is the impact the presentation tool. Hopefully I am audible to all of you. Yes, so just before going, just going to be highlight in what
manner we are browsing. Sir, I think there is an audio breaking.
Yes, sir.
Audio is breaking a little
bit. Is it okay, ma'am? Now is it okay?
Yeah,
is it okay
it's
now?
Better now. It's better now.
Yeah. Yeah, so before going to the interactive presentation tool, just I'm going to highlight in what manner we are crossing the lockdowns. So in the lockdown periods, we are spending much time with our mobile phones only. Then the next important things to survival in the lockdown periods with Wi-Fi only. So without Wi-Fi, we cannot be survived, because at least in a single day, in a day, you are attending a lot of classes or webinar and all. So without the Wi-Fi, we cannot be survived in the lockdown periods. And next thing, so we are classing daily at least 1 or 2 virtual conferencing. Now we are using as a Zoom meeting, otherwise you may go for the like WebEx or a Google Meet. So daily life, we are moving to the virtual conferencing mode only. The next thing, we are much focused on the virtual learning. Why I'm focusing the sense, we are depends on much of the technology devices, but in the context of the classroom, some kind of lack knowledge is there. That's why I'm focusing. Even we are using the laptop devices, mobile devices, 24/7 access. Then parallelly, we are getting a lot of wisdom, a lot of input from attending a lot of web conferences or seminars, this kind of programs too. The biggest challenges for us for engaging the participants in the virtual mode. Because for teaching things through the virtual mode is very easy now, but the biggest problem, biggest challenge to the teacher side, as the learner side, the teacher side I'm particularly focusing, for engaging the participants on the status is very big question mark. That is why I'm recommending the 3 E's. It's a solution for all of us. If you are merging the 3 E's in the classroom more fruitful. If you are skip on any kind of E's, in these 3 E's, if you're skipping any single E, you cannot be survive also, particularly in this kind of virtual meeting. One is called engaging. So the biggest challenge, I already pointed out that the engaging is lot of lack of noise happen during the virtual meeting. That's why we have to think in what manner we have to engage the participants through this kind of virtual meeting. That encouraging. Normally in the classroom, at least we are giving some kind of encouraging words like good or bad. But in the context of the virtual meeting, even we are not allow the participant to talk us. So we are, even the before the meeting also, the host may warn us or they may give us some kind of information, kindly mute from here. So therefore, there is no way to be interact with the teacher and the students. And parallel, we are not giving some kind of encouragement words to the students. That's why we have to look on this one. Even we have to provide the platform to the students to share their ideas. Parallel, the teachers may give some kind of encouraging word. Then one more thing, e-tools. We have to find a specific very good or very apt tools for the particular content delivery. If you're adding the 3 E's, really the classroom's more fruitful. Now I move to that with my presentations. When you talk about the interactive presentation, the interaction may happen between the 3 components. One is called student and content. In the context of the student and content, it's focused, the delivery, the final it reaches the relevance only. Without the relevance, the teachers cannot be others. What is the students cannot grasp the content from the student side, teacher side. In the context of the teacher and the content, the final output is commercial expertise. The same way the interaction interaction happened between the teacher and student in the way of relationship. So now you see, I'm merging the two things only. But where we can get the better benefit in the sense when we interact the three things, when you go for interaction between the three things, teacher, student, and content. When you do the interaction in the three aspects, damn sure the meaningful engagement may happen. So if you are avoiding any one important things, you could not be go for the interaction may less as well the engagement may less in the context of the classroom practice. Partially, I'm talking about the virtual meeting. That's why I much focus on the which are the interactive platform tools. It may in engaging the participants to involve much during our virtual meeting and stuff. Once again, I may highlighting in what manner the interaction may happen in the sense through the content interaction. For example, when you give the PPT, apparently we may ask some kind of cues questions. So like the content way, the interaction may happen. The next to happen, the communication. So in what manner communication is in the teacher-student communication. Apparently we can ask some kind of poll question. We can ask some oral question to the student. That kind of communication way, we can make the classroom more interactive. Then apparently we may know the term synchronous and asynchronous mode. The biggest challenges in we are getting the answer from the student whether we are getting the synchronous mode or asynchronous mode. So as a teacher, we have to look on this one. Once you find this answer, in what manner you are going to transact the delivery, whether you are going with the synchronous mode or asynchronous mode, apparently we have to think in what manner we are getting the output from the student side also. So if you are finding the answer, damn sure we can easily find out the perfect tool for delivering the things to the students. The next thing, just time over to the next. Yeah. So these are the tools I may focusing. Due to the time fact, I'm not focusing all. I may demonstrate one or two tools only. In the context of the interactive content, in what manner we can make it the content interactions, they have depends on the three tools I'm suggesting to you. Near port, backlit, testes, blended space. These are the
class attend bunny
to make the interactions in the content. In the content itself, a lot of interaction may happen. Just I may do the demonstration. The next thing, how we can make that presentation while using this kind of online tools like Meeting Pulse, WebEx, Slido, Vocalabs, Mentimeter. These are the tools. It's like a survey poll only, but having the plenty of features. If you are using this kind of tools, is making the classrooms more fruitful as well as the some kind of brainstorming activity you can incorporate while delivering the lecture itself. That is why I'm suggesting this application for interactive presentation. Then next to spell, I may focusing on interactive whiteboard tools. Bigger challenges, I already mentioned the bigger challenges in the virtual meeting. We cannot use the whiteboard. Even the Zoom, there is a options called share as a white screen. But in the context of the Google Meet and all, and now only they're incorporating the Jamboard into the Google Meet. Previously, that option is not there. Even if you are using the Jamboard also, the bigger challenge to us to writing, because we cannot write it like a whiteboard we are using the normal classes, because it's not be user-friendly way we are writing. That is why I'm suggesting some of the online tools. It may helping us to convert, even if you're a mathematics teacher, you can, if you know the LaTeX code, you can type the LaTeX code, finally it comes as a mathematical equation, if you know the LaTeX code. For this, the whiteboard fee, that tool is a very unique, because once you type the LaTeX code, finally it comes as a mathematical equation. So that kind of tool you can adopt for delivering a mathematics content to the students. Then open board is totally so open source. Jamboard, Stormboard, Miro, and Liveboard. These are the tools is make the classrooms more fruitful in the way of whiteboard based. Just I'm going to skip directly move to the demonstration. I'm moving to the demonstration. Yes. So that tool first I'm talking to you is a Nearport. I'm going to the Nearport. So the entire presentation I'm focusing on the demonstration base only. I request the participant, if possible, kindly install the Nearport application on mobile phone. I hope now you are seeing my mobile screen too. So there is a application called Nearport. Just I highlight the icon of the Nearport. Apparently, you can install it if you have the mobile space in the sense. Then only you can understand in what manner the Nearport is to be working from the student's perspective, from the student's side. Just I'm showing the icon of the Nearport. Yeah. See here, this is I make it a discussion forum as a folder. There you are finding the tool name, the first row, the first icon that is called Nearport. I request all to install this application on mobile phone. Then after that, you can explore it, how it will be working. Now, parallelly, I'm doing the web tool based demonstration. Login, the skipping, logout, then I can from the starting and how to sign up. Then after that, I may demonstrate how we can use this tool for our content delivery, as well as in what manner it may helping us to do the interactions. That things I may focus on to you. Yes. So just I log out. This is the home page of Nearport. For reaching this Nearport, you can go with nearport.com. Nearport.com is a URL ID. There you are getting the lot of options like students login, teachers login, admission login. As a teacher, we students with this code only. So once you created, once you post the content, you can go for the hosting the content or delivering the content. Once you go for the delivering or the live mode or the synchronous mode or asynchronous mode, you are getting one code. You have to share the code to the students may connect with you. So this is the way we have to connect our students. Now, as a teacher, we can go for the teacher sign up. You already know the two differences between sign up and login. Sign up for the first time user, login for the user you already have in the account. For the first time user, you can go with sign up for free. Once you go with sign up for free, and I'm talking about the free versions things only, even the paid versions available. This free version is supporting nearly 40 students at the same time, but there is no limitation for the number of content uploading. Only the limitations for, you can be organize a event at a time, only one event, or at a time only you have host only one content you have to share the students. At a time is single only. Parallelly, the other limitation, maximum 40 students may join with a single activity. That's only the limitation in the free version. Once you go with this page, it's asking to be sign up with Google. Better to sign up with your Google account. Because once you give the username password, there's a chance you may forget the username. Better to give this sign up with Google, only one thing, but don't connect with your mail ID which you connected for personal details like bank details as well as the Aadhaar card. So better you can create a specific mail ID to connect, you can use this unique mail ID to connect this kind of online tools. Once you go with sign up with Google, automatically goes to the homepage. But I already have the account. That's why what I'm going to do, I'm going to be go with login the process. Just I'm going with the login. Once I go with the login, now I'm moving to the login process because I'm already having the account and I'm going with the login with Google. In the login with Google, I'm selecting the mail which I'm already created account. I'm giving us here this mail, thealgumok@gmail.com. So this way here to be sign up or login. It's a very simple process. And the main important things of the Nearport is very user-friendly tool. You could not be, normally if you look onto the other tools, you may get plenty of features, plenty of options that may go the left side, right side, top and down. See the user friendliness. You can find only the one main option that is called create. Other options not much needed. The side only the report Nearport library. So this is a home page of the Nearport. I'm already created this much of lessons. For creating a new lessons, you can go with the create options. So I'm going to do, I'm going to create a lesson. And one more thing, recently the Google, the Nearport, they are integrating with the Zoom. Even you can use the Zoom, this kind of live interaction, like face-to-face interaction also, with the use of application you can do parallelly. So you can share your content, parallelly you can use this kind of face-to-face interaction, what we are doing now. The same manner we can use this tool also. Then for this, first you can go with the create options. In the create options, you may get the two options like lessons, as well as the videos. And one more new options, it's good. What is the option in the sense? The Google Slides, there is an add-on. Suppose you are regularly using the Google Slides, what you have to do, you can install the add-ons Nearport. Automatically, the add-on software of Nearport, it default incorporated in the Google Slides. You can control the entire thing of the Nearport with the use of Google Slide itself. So no need to go for the Nearport.com separately. You can use your Google Slide. Then from the Google Slide, you can access the Nearport. That is the one unique in this tool. I am going with the lesson because I'm going to create a new lessons. In this new lessons, see here, what are the features you may find from here. This is another simple interface. So once you click the create options in the lessons, you are getting this interface. Suppose this is a title. This is a title of the lesson. Today I am going to talk about the interactive presentation. Therefore, I put the title as an IP session, interactive. So I'm giving the title like this. This is the title of my presentation. Okay, interactive presentation as a session. Now I am going to add the content. I already mentioned that the interaction may happen between the content to content, teachers to learner, and we are going to give some kind of engagement activity. Once you provide engagement activity, some kind of interaction happen to the student participant side. Now for this, after typing the title, I'm going to add slides. It's like a PowerPoint slide. We can add the slides one by one. But here we are adding the slide in the base of content. We are not adding the slides. We are adding as a slide as a content. So the content may be video content or audio content or any simulation content or in a 3D animation content. You can add any content as a slide. Now I'm click the add slide. Once I click the add slide, it goes to the other interface. There is a content. I already mentioned there's a content interaction. This much of content engagement tools are available, features are available. Fairly, if you click the activities, you are getting this much of activities are available. I hope you're already familiar with our Swayam is talking about the four quadrant approach. Once you enroll the Swayam courses, you can understand the four quadrant. One is called e-content, second one is called e-tutorial, second component. The third and fourth component activities as well as the assignments. Here, the content is to be helping us to go for the first two quadrant. The content is nothing but the video content as well as the text material. The text material may be in any mode. It may be a video, it may be audio. In any manner, you can share the resource to the students. The content is nothing but the Swayam first and second quadrant. If you click the activities, you are finding the activities. Like you can go with open-ended question, matching the first, QSS, Flipgrid, Dropit, draw it, collaborate board, like that you can keep some kind of engaging task to the students as an activity. So this much of features are available. I am going to highlight the features. So as a teacher, how we can share our material as a video material to the students. See this case video, I am clicking the video. Once I click the video content, and first adding the video content. In the video content, once you click it, it automatically leads to the next page. See here, it leads to the next page. Now it leads the next page. It comes to the next screen like video library, YouTube, and my video, and upload video. If you already having the video, you can upload it. Suppose if you have the YouTube channel, and they are giving a lot of resources here. This is an airport already given some kind of repository materials. If you want a max material, you can upload the max video. A lot of max video also is there. But now I like to go with my video. Therefore, I'm doing YouTube. In this YouTube, I'm type my YouTube channel. So I'm typing my YouTube channel. Once I go with my YouTube channel, automatically my content is visible. So these are the materials, which are the videos available in the website. Now I'm going to be sharing some material to my students as a video. Therefore, I'm selecting how to share video in the Google Meet. I'm selecting this video and share it. I'm saving it. See here. Now I'm adding the first content as a video. I'm adding the first content as a video. Once you add it, it automatically goes to the content as a first slide. Now see here. Now it's moving. Even this video is 2.53 minutes, but I like to project only the 1 minute to my students, not for the 2.53. Therefore, here there is an option. I hope you are seeing the option, the right options. Once you click trim, you can trim the video size. So I can go with only, I like to go with only the 48 seconds only. So like that, we can trim the video. We can minimize the video. Then after this, click trim. This one options, we can trim the video. Even if you want to extend the video later, you can do later. Then another features to adding the contents. Now see here, I'm adding the video content. Apparently I'm going to add some kind of polls, like some people having the experience to attend the course in the Coursera. The Coursera, during the presentation, during the video itself, they ask some kind of questions. In between some kind of quiz question. See here, there is a 45 seconds video. In between, I want to ask some questions. See here, this is the time. So I want to ask the questions here. I want to ask the questions in this particular 6 seconds. What I can do, click and add an activity. Once I click and add an activity, it asks whether you can go with open-ended question or multiple choice question. I like to go with open-ended or multiple choice. I like to go with multiple choice. It means that I'm interacting with the content What is the content? I'm delivering the content as a video, but apparently I'm going to add some questions, like activity I'm going to add as a content for the students. So now the questions. Google Meet is a video conferencing tool. So just because that video is related to Google Meet, I'm giving the options like true, false. So you can ask as a true or false question, then add answer. If you need, you can go with add answer, then otherwise go with save. Now what did happen? I am adding one video. In this video is 48 minutes, so 48 seconds only. In the 48 seconds, the 6 seconds, there is a question. Suppose I want to add another question, I can keep the cursor, I can add the next question. Like that, we can add n number of questions at any word. So this is way this tool is unique. We can add in between the video itself some questions. After this, you feel that is okay, then go with save. You can fix the time if you need in the sense. You can fix the time for each question if you need in the sense. Or we skip it. Then finally, you can go with this. So finally, you can go with this save. So I'm going to save. So now the first slide is okay. The first slide is a slide of your video content. But the video content consists of some poll question also, some kind of true or false. Now the first slide is uploaded. See here, this is the first slide. Now I move to the second content I'm going to upload. I'm going with add slide. I'm going to add slide. So we already explore as a video content. Therefore, I'm skipping to the other, that is called slide. Suppose you want to add the PowerPoint slide, you can use the slide. Suppose you want to share some website link, you can go with web content. I want to share some Nearpod 3D images. So if you go with the Nearpod 3D, lot of 3D images are available. Suppose I'm a science background, I want to share the animal cell. I can select the animal cell and click done. So what it means, I am sharing the second content as the animal cells to students. The student may see these animal cell interactions, their side itself with the use of mobile phone or a laptop. So I added the second content. Similarly, I'm going with the third content. So for this, I'm going with the simulations. Here, lot of simulations they are providing for free. Suppose I am the elementary school's mathematics teacher or a middle school teachers, you can select what subject you want. Suppose I like to go with science as a high school and with the science kind of lot of PhD, the interactive simulations things are there. Suppose I like to go with this interactions, so this kind of interactive simulations, select this particular template and go with that. So now I'm adding the third content as a simulation content. See the content delivery. The first is a video, second is a 3D images, the third is a simulation. Therefore, the content way lot of interactions happen. Now, if I want to show the virtual reality, VR field trip, it's another content VR. It provides lot of VR as a free virtual reality tool. Suppose I want to share the VR of the Taj Mahal. The student want to explore how the Taj Mahal, the view is there. In their own end, in the sense, I can select the Taj Mahal. Even lot of images are available. This is called, the panoramic 360 video, 360 images, that the images only. I'm clicking is done. Once I click done, the next material added as a field trip. Now you are seeing as a field trip content. Then I'm going with the add slide. Like that, you can go with the n number of materials. Suppose I like to share it's a BBC video, some informative video related to my specific subject. I'm going to the BBC video. then you can type the content, search the content. Otherwise, you can select the kind of, suppose I like to share this video to my students, select this video and done it. So this was the BBC worldwide video. Now I added the 5 content, but the 5 content, each one's different each one. So this is called content interaction. Here, I'm not sharing the content of a single mode. I'm using a video mode, image mode, then simulation mode, field trip mode, as well as the other way, the video mode. So if you go with the swipe, you know the swipe presentations. Here, the plenty of swipe presentation videos there. Otherwise, if you have one presentation swipe, you can upload it. If you want to create, you can upload it. Suppose I like to show the Asia's images, add as a swipe file. I'm adding as a 6 content as a swipe. Then I'm going with the next content as the audio. Suppose you want to share some audio material to the students. You can develop your own audio content and share it. Suppose you want to share as a PDF file, PDF upload, like PPT or any material you want to share as a Swayam second quadrant, you can use the PDF viewer. Due to the time fact, I'm skipping this one. So this is here, much features are available to sharing as a resources. So this are the is good for the sharing the resources. Now I move to the activities. So I'm going to do the activities. The activities, a lot of activities are available, nearly 10 activities is a free version. This 10 activities you can use as a free. If you go with the paid version, you can get it plenty of features, but I'm using more than 5 years in the free version only. So I don't feel any kind of difficulties to use this one. Suppose as a science teacher, you want to get some drawing based information from the students as an activity, go with a drawing option. If you go with the drawing, automatically the next, you can select the time. So this is for the activity page. So here I'm going to the 7th content as a drawing activity. It moves the next level. So there I'm asking the question. So draw any virus, what is that icon? So any virus as a diagram, draw any virus symbol. So this is a question I'm asking. If you want to fix the time, you can fix the time. So due to the time, so I'm not feel that it's more comfortable for fixing the time now. That's why I'm skipping this one. I'm going with the save. So now the next, sorry, there is a spelling mistake. If you want to edit also, you can do edit. Just I'm going back. Once I go with the save, automatically goes to the content page creations. Now see here, the 7th content is drawing. And suppose I want to edit, I can double click it and do the editing. So due to the time fact, I'm skipping this one. Otherwise I can do the draw, double click it and do the editing. See here, it's going for the editing version. Just I'm changing the spelling. So I'm changing the spelling as a symbol. So whenever you need any changes, you can do at any time. You can do the editing work at any time. Even you can delete it. So now I'm added the drawing it as an activity. Then I'm going to add an activity. I'm going with the next activities. In the activities, just I like to go with the time to claim. Time to claim is a very good tool. Like a gamification mode, we can conduct some kind of poll. For that, I'm going to go with the time to climb. If you go with time to climb, it's like a quiz only, but the participants, they may select the own avatar. That's why I told this tool is may increase the encouragement also to the student side. I'm asking a simple question to the students. Google Classroom is an LMS. It's a statement I'm giving. I'm giving the options like this, true. True, false. So here the correct answer. That's only one question. Even you can add some kind of other question also. It's an LMS, the first question. Apparently I want to add the next question based on the images. So I'm going to add answer, sorry, this for the add of answer. I'm going to the next question only. I'm going to add question. Here I'm going to add images based on the images I'm going to add, ask the questions. Therefore, I'm going to be upload some images from my desktop. For this, I'm going to upload options. Even this is me supporting the Google Drive also. So this is symbol. This is a, I hope you know, it's called OER, Creative Commons license. So there I'm selecting some images. So I am selecting some of the images. Yes, I'm clicking open. So immediately the image may open. Here, based on the image, I may ask the question. The image is related to. So this is called non-derivative. So write derivatives, non-derivatives, non-derivatives. So I can give the options like this. If you go with the third option, you can go with the share alike. So like that, I'm giving you three options. As a teacher, I can select the correct options. Then go with save. So it means that in this activity, I'm adding two questions. And after that, I'm going to save. So once it go with the save, it comes the next slide. See here, the next slide is the time to plan. Then the next is the last slide I'm going to do for you. The last slide, just I like to go with this one, like collaborate board. Like you can go with some kind of collaborative activity in a single whiteboard. In a single whiteboard or a dashboard, I'm asking the question, how do you feel about this tool? How do you feel about this tool? This is an open question to all. Then you have to give the responses. Even as a teacher, we can select the board color. Suppose I like to change the color as a blackboard color, black color. So you can change the color and go with save. So this is where we can add the plenty of activity as a resource. Suppose you feel to be add later, some activities here as a 10 slide. You can go here, add slide, and go with the content and then activate the you can go with any resources or activity. The finally, one more thing I'm focusing, open-ended question. So otherwise, poll or fill in the blanks, use Flipgrid. I hope you know what is my Flipgrid. There is a unique platform, Flipgrid, for sharing the views through the video mode. The video mode may support maximum 5 minutes duration only. The people, they may share the views or ideas in a video mode. We can use the Flipgrid options. Even the Flipgrid is they incorporate it directly in the Nearpod. You can use the Nearpod Flipgrid also if you need, in the sense. Then the match the first is nothing but the match the following. Please, I request all to explore from my run. There's plenty of tools are there. If you're focusing, I can be finish the entire thing. That's why I'm skipping this one. Now I like to go with 9 content. So 9 content, don't think this is only the content. This is here, lessons consist of video, simulation, field trip, video, as well as some kind of activities. Then after completing, this is like a lesson plan. So before going to the classes, you can make it some lesson plan. Then after making the lesson plan, go with save and exit. So these are things you have to do well in advance. Before come to the classes, or before meeting this kind of virtual meeting, you can finish this task well in advance. It's like nothing but a normal lesson plan. So when we are writing the lesson plan, before coming to the, taking the class, we are writing the lesson plan, or we are preparing the PPT, you know, before coming to the class. The same manner, I am preparing a lessons. This lessons is come as in the chronology. So once you save, no, automatically it comes to the home page. So here in the home page, based on the chronologic order, which material you have created now or which lessons you have created recently, it may comes first. It may comes first. This is a material I created now, IP session, that's the title. Now I'm going to be host, I'm going to organize. This is a second part. The first part for creating the lessons, you have to be do well in advance. Once you come to the normal classrooms, even this tool is unique. You can use it after the COVID, post-COVID also. Suppose in your classroom, there is no LCD projector. You know, now I'm talking about the normal classroom. You don't have LCD projector. Even there is a power failure. That's why you cannot be use the LCD projector. What you have to do, you can use your laptop and share the screen to the entire student's mobile phone. Because the students having the mobile phone, you can access, you can share your PPT or you can share the material which you have uploaded in the notebook to the student through the mobile phone without depends on the any tool. Only the things you have to share the code to the students. Now I'm going to tell how to organize it. For organizing, after uploading the content, keep the cursor above the title. The title which I created is IP sessions. Once you keep the cursor, you are getting the three options. That's why I told there is no need to go for live Zoom separately. You can start Zoom parallel with the lessons. For that, you can go with the live participant plus Zoom. We already zoomed, that's why I'm skipping this one. Now the beta versions are available. Those are, even this is a beta version, free one. The free version, the limitation, he knows only the 40 minutes only the Zoom, that only the limitations. But if I skip this live to Zoom, you can go with the live participant. There is no time boundary in this. You can go with 1 hour, 3 hours with the use of other softwares. Okay, with the Google Meet and all, you can use it. If you want to be connected student with Zoom, the face-to-face, you can use this feature. Otherwise, go live participation. And the two main things important. So one is called live participant student face. Live participant for synchronous mode. Synchronous mode, the student as well as the teacher should be both in online. If the both are online, we can do this kind of tools. Then only the students perceive what manner the interaction happened between the teacher student parallel with the content. So that is called live participation. Even the student face, nothing but asynchronous homework mode. Even you can assign this assignment task or assignment activity to the student in the home also. That also possible. Now I'm going to the demonstration as a live mode. I request the participants kindly connect with me with this code. As a teacher, I can go with the live participants. Once I go with the live participants, immediately in my display, you may get code. This is a code, each time should be different. Suppose I am getting code now, 5-digit code. The code may be differ after 10 minutes when I use this same lesson I want to share to other group of lessons. So each time the code may differ. I request the participants kindly use this option. You can go with joinearport.com. See here, joinearport.com, and give the code 6HPZM. Apparently, I'm opening the other tab. See here, this is an Nearport homepage. As a student, what they can do, they can go with Nearport, joinearport.com. So I'm already copying this code. Sorry, I'm not copying this code. See here, I am copying this code. 6HPZM. I request anyone can share this code in the chat box. It may help into others to connect the things. Then I can open this one. I can paste it here. So then this is student. I'm talking about student. The students may give it. After pasting the code, they may connect with our classroom. You can go with the nearport.com. The otherwise you can go with join here. I'm showing the teacher screen now. This is a teacher screen. And close here. So in the teacher screen, the right side, the left side, you are always getting the code 6HPZM. The code the students want to join like this, joinearport.com. After that, it asks the code. The students may give the code. Once the students giving the code, it asks to be login. The students can be logging with their Gmail account. So one person joins. See here, Shabira. Thank you, Shabira, to join. Now Shabira joined to my lecture. Now parallelly, I'm coming to the student screen. In the student screen, I'm already given as a code. That's why he's asking to log in with Google. Go with the login with Google, because then only we can see the students' names. Then I am giving the other mail ID for this. So I'm giving the other mail ID as a student mail ID. I'm giving the password. Now this is a student view. See here. Now it moves. Yeah, so it's asked whether this name is okay. I'm going with yes to continue. So I'm connecting as a student with Cyber Tiago. Yeah, this is a student view. This is a student view. So now I'm going back to the teacher's view. Still two students are there. I request others also can join. The problem, there's just two students. At least anyone can give the answer in this. One student's color is a green color, other students a red color. Any idea? Because the green color represents those who are online. The red color represents those who are offline. It means that they may be online, but they may watch other than my content. So here from this, we can know who is online, who is not. Even the people who may online, they may watch other like YouTube, Facebook. We can warn them based on the students' names from the red color, if you found the sense. I request others also can join, at least nearly 40 members, 68 members are there. I request people to join, very simple. Go to the Nearport. Those who are using a mobile phone also, I do the demonstration from the mobile phone. See here, I hope now you are seeing my mobile phone. Yes, so those who are installed the Nearport application, otherwise if you don't have a space, you can directly go with nearport.com. There you can go with the Nearport. You can type the code. I'm just type the code. Apparently, I'm opening the mobile. Yeah, this is my mobile screen. See here. I'm going with login with Google. Sorry, I'm exist this. I'm giving the code first. The code for this activity is differ. I'm giving the code. This already connect the other question. I'm going to quite able to come. Yes. Now see here. They say two content. Only two students are still joined. Here the control with the teachers only. Even the students cannot see the video content which I'm sharing to. See here, the first video content is visible to the students. This is the content I'm sharing to them. The students can watch the video like this. The video content. So the student, this is student view I'm showing. Parallel, I'm opening the teacher's view. I'm going back. So once I change the second content, so the video content, I'm moving to the second content. So now the third, three, there is a 10 content in down you're seeing out of 10 content, the third content I'm showing to the students. The third content is here, 3D images. So this is a student side. This is a student view I'm showing. The students can do manipulations. They can explore from their end. So see here, I'm using two browser. Mozilla Firefox is a student. Google Chrome is a student, teacher screen. So from this, I'm doing the demonstration. See here, I'm doing the manipulations that students can do this kind of interaction from the end. Suppose I like to move the next content. This is a teacher screen. It's a teacher screen. Now I already given some times to them. That's why I like to change the third content to the students. I can move it from here. So this is the everything, the permission with the teachers only. The students cannot skip from the second content to third content. See here, I could not be moved to the next content. Only I can see this content only after the teachers can move the next content. Now I move to the teacher screen. The teachers now, as a teacher, I'm into the fourth content. The fourth content, the content, see what's the content I posted, it's a simulation. So this is the view of the teacher screen. Apparently I moved to the student screen. Now the student screen you are seeing. The student screen, you are seeing some kind of simulations. So I can change this one. So I don't know what is exactly this activity because I'm not familiar with much physics. I don't know what is this one, speed. So if you an input, automatically it gives the output. So that kind of PhD simulation is there. Those are physics background, you can understand what is this one. So I'm not much familiar. You can change the angles. Okay. You can change the angles and all, you can explore from here. Now, as a teacher, I like to move to the next content. Still only two students are there. I request others also, if it's possible, kindly join. Thank you, the three more students. One more student joined. So the student name is Zainab Zain. Thank you, Zainab, to join with us. So now the Zainab. So as a teacher, I can see who is joining, who is at this point. Everything from my end, I can see. Now I move to the fourth content. Fifth content. As a, this is I think, yeah, this is a virtual VR box. Now this is Taj Mahal. So this is a teacher's view. I'm showing the teacher's view. The same views come to the student side also. Now see here, this is student screen. I hope Zainab and the other two members, they may see the screen. You can change the positions. You can explore how the Taj Mahal. The things, instead of touching the wall by your hand, you are touching with your mouse or your mobile screen. So this is way you can perceive how the Taj Mahal looking happened. So once you go directly, also the same experience you may get it. So this is called VR. Even if you have the virtual box, you can get that kind of experience through experience, virtual reality experiences. Now, as a teacher, I like to move to the next content. So I hope, I feel that this much of time is enough for showing this material to students. I move to the next content. Once I move the next content, this is called a video. So once again, I'm sharing the video content with BBC. So all devices may be working. This is teacher's view. I request the participants kindly see whether in your end you are able to see the video content, the same video content. So this is student side. This is student side. It's somewhat video, no? It takes little time. Yeah. Now the students can view the videos from the RAM. So what it's like is share the screen. I'm sharing the screen of my laptop screen to the other users. That is why I told, even you can use this tool in the normal classrooms. Suppose you are giving the lecture direct to the students. Yeah. So I'm giving the lecture in the direct classroom, but you don't have the LCD access in your classroom. You can share your material like this to the student's mobile phone from your laptop itself. Then I like to move the next activity. Therefore, as a teacher, I'm changing the activity. Now see here, the next activity as a Microsoft SWOI content, like resources. So it's a teacher's view. It is a teacher's view. Parallel, I'm opening the student view in the other browser. Now see here, this is an Asia content, Taj Mahal, then location, then countries. You can explore, you can click and explore one by one. So you can click and explore the content of the Taj Mahal and other things. This is like a SWOI content. Lot of materials are available. You can explore from your end. So this is where the students may understand the material impact from the student side. Normally, while you presenting, you are only using the PPT material. But here, apparently, the students can see and explore the material which you share to them from the end itself. This is called engaging. Here, the students are engaging much compared to the normal way of presenting. So this tool is making the engagement more 100% much to the student side. Now I move to this teacher screen. In this teacher screen, I'm going with the next slide. If you go with the next slide, draw any virus. I hope the Zainab, Sabir, and Cyber Tiago, they're getting this screen. While I'm opening my student screen. In this student screen, the students may use the pen and draw any virus. Just I'm drawing this kind of symbol. This is a student screen. Just once I submit, automatically I move to the teacher screen. See here, in the teacher screen, you can see the students' answer responses from here. Now Zainab is working. Thank you, Zainab. So now Zainab is progress. Cyber Tiago has also progress. This is Zainab image. Now progress, little time, so because my network is very little poor. That's, yeah, now see here, my image comes here as a student image. So even the teacher may download the entire screen. So here, if you have 40 students, you can see the 40 dashboard of each individuals. From this, you can know who submitted the assignment task, who is not submitted assignment task. Now I like to move to the next task. If I go with the next task, you can see the next task, see here. The task is talking, what is the activity I'm given here in the sense, like this activity, what is this? You see, what is the activity I'm posted? Yeah, that is called mount climb. Yeah, like a gamification mode activity. Yeah, so only the things, the teachers can start the event. Only the teachers may start the event. When the teachers start the event, this is, I'm showing the teacher screen. I'm moving to the teacher screen, student screen. Here the students can select their own avatar. So I like this avatar and select as a start. After selecting the avatar, click start. So what it means, this is symbol we represent. This is an avatar is represent myself, Cyber Tiago. I request a Zainab and other one more person to select your own avatar, please. Then only you can explore how it will be working. So like that, each individual, this is a student screen. I'm talking, this is a student screen. The students can select their own avatar, and after selecting the avatar, now see here, now the Sabira. This is an avatar of Sabira. I request a Zainab also select one avatar and click start. So yeah, now see here, now Zainab. There is a three people that I'm going to conduct small competition. What is the competition between the three members? Though who's reaching the top mountain, they are the winner. Like a race, I'm going to conduct a small competition. What they're going to do, the three person can play. You have to give the responses for the two questions in a very fast. So here you can give that scores are counted based on the speed as well as the accuracy. You can give the response very fast as to the accuracy. Now, as a teacher, I'm going to activate this teacher screen. It is a teacher screen. as a teacher, I activate this activity, click start button. Immediately, the student side, the questions may display. So now I'm activating, I move to the student screen. This is student screen. The students may find the questions. Now the questions, Google Classrooms and LMS. Select the response from the, this is student screen. It is a student screen. So I'm clicking the true answer. Yeah, the first question over, so I fixed 30 seconds, that's why it's moving. So you can wait for up to the times to be end. 4 seconds, 3 seconds, 2 seconds, 1 second. Now time up. Now there's a competition between the three students. You can see the running race between the three people. Now the leading by the Sabira. Sabira is leading. Myself last. The second question to you. So you can select the responses. So the time is 20, there's a seconds, I fix it 30 seconds. Yeah, now the question's over. Yeah, so we will see the position of the each individual. The position of the each individual. So this is student screen. Yeah, congrats. So myself, Sabira is second. Zainab is the third. This is a portion of the each individual. This is a portion of the each individuals. Like we can conduct this kind of gamification mode. This mode, it makes the students more engaging. Then I move to the next activity, like collaborations. So here, automatically the collaboration board, the site is collaborative board. Would you like to like approve the students' comments? No. So once I click no, they immediately the board display to very end. This is a teacher screen. Just I'm going to the student screen. Here you can, I'm giving us a very good. I'm giving us a comments like very good. As a student, I'm giving the post. Once I keep post, automatically the board is visible to the all also. So I'm giving us a comment is very good. I request other 4 to 3 members also give the comments. Yeah, so Sabir has given us a good. So like collaboration, in a single wallpaper or a single whiteboard, all the students may contribute their own idea. You can ask these questions, how we can engage the students through this kind of online tool. The people may give their contributions like this. Now, Anbu and all is giving a very good. So like that, each individual, they given the answer. Even I can give the like symbol or unlike symbol. So like the Facebook, what are the options are there, we can do it. So this way we can engage the participant with this kind of tool. So you may enjoy this one. And how we can be stop these presentations. So once as a teacher, I'm showing this teacher screen. Once you go with this, there is an option called end session. Once click the end session, click yes, automatically the session may close. Even those who are connecting with me, there's a 4 students connecting, no. Their screens, nothing visible. See here, I'm going to the back to the student screen. You are getting this information. The session end, the teacher has ended the session. It means that the students cannot get any material related to the previous things which I'm talking to you. So this way, the tool is more engaging. That's why I told interaction. Here, the interaction between the content to content, teacher to student, then with the students also interact with the mobile phone. The students are interact with the activity. Lot of interactions happen between a single tool in the single tool itself. So now it's sharply 6:23. Due to the time fact, I'm skipping the other headings. Just I'm going to compile because other things you have to be explored because plenty of tools are available. Just I'm talking about the only the interactive content as well as this tool is me helping to interacting with the teacher and student also, like in airport backlet. Then parallelly, I may give this other list, interactive presentation tool. During the meeting, you can ask some kind of question with the use of this kind of tools. Then interactive whiteboard tools, you can use this tool for interactive presentations. Then go with the meeting. These are the tools names, screenshot I'm showing you. That is called WebEx. That's called Slido. Then Nearport, but there is a time limitation, so I had to finish at 6:30. Sometimes I cannot do the boards. What is that? some interactive whiteboard. I will share my website address there. You may find out the plenty of materials. From this, you can explore how the interactive whiteboards are working. I'm sharing my website link. From this, you can understand how it's working. Then Padlet, Flipgrid, GymKit, SVP. These are the tool it's making the classroom more interactive. Then widgets, the mobile applications on my desktop. So now sharp is 6:30, that's why I'm going to wind up. I'm going to share my simple thanks to this much of people. First I had to share the Google search and Google image. Then SlideShot contributed to find these some kind of unique things from the SlideShot, really thanks to website and mobile apps creators. Because due to that only we are sitting patient and we are exploring a lot of things. And thanks to the reference authors, because I quoted gamification, some kind of pedagogy things. For that, I want to share my thanks to the reference author. Thanks to MS PowerPoint. Thanks to my teachers, because I'm reaching. Thanks to my students, because of only I'm graduating. Thanks to my colleagues of Central Institute of Kerala, from the HOD to the non-teaching faculty. So I'm sharing thanks to them. And particularly, I share the sincere thanks to the Dr. Dashin Ma, Central Institute of Kerala, Computer Science Department, to provide such a wonderful opportunity for me. Meenam, I hope somewhat I may satisfy your needs. Thank you, Dashin Ma, to provide a wonderful chance. And thanks to the other organizers. I do not know the names of the people. Thanks to them to provide such a wonderful opportunity. Thanks to all the participants. And thank you all, Jay Bharat. If you have any questions, you can ask me. Then apparently I may share my website address. It may help you to explore more information related to the content. First, I'm sharing the link within tools. So I'm just copying my blog website, Google site address. There, if you click the technology as a link, you may find the plenty of materials related to the technology. I'm sharing the link now. Parallelly, you can ask your questions if you have any queries in the sense. So 2 seconds, just I'm copying this link. Yeah, so I'm copying this link. I'm pasting this link in our Zoom, in the chat box.
Kyakusa, thank you so much for giving a wonderful session over here.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you.
And so, there, tell me, sir.
So once I post your website address, okay. I'm trying to post it. Thank you, ma'am. You can further link.
There is a question from one query from one participant. How to combine Nearpod with the Google Slides? Please do it and show.
Yeah. So the Google Slide is like a online presentation tool. That is why I told you can use the Google Slide also. This tool as an add-on software. Add-on tool is available, but in the Google Slide, you cannot be making the student as interactive. You cannot make it as interactive, only the presentation from your end only. Even if you are using the Slido app in the add-on, we can go some kind of interactions. Only the Google Slides, only for the presentation purpose we are using. We could not use that platform for interactive purpose. Even your slide, if you are sharing that content through the link, they may get it, but you cannot conduct any kind of activity in this, in the Google Slide. But in these Google Nearpod or a Slido, you can organize a lot of activities in this. In this manner, the interaction may increase a lot. Yes. The next question, ma'am. So apparently I'm sending the website address, the first, that is called DigiGogi. If you click it, first page, you may get my profile. You can go with, there is a technology. Once you click the technology, you may get the plenty of materials related to the tech. Technology as Google Slide and Nearpod also. Which platform is highly comparable to the teachers? Comparable, what is it? Highly comparable in the sense? In which context, Jnana Subramanian sir, you are asking? Which platform is highly comparable?
Sorry, sir, comfortable. Comfortable.
Comfortable. Okay. Comfortable. Okay. So the comfortable is based on the teachers, sir. Okay. Suppose if you are very good in the technology aspects, you may be comfortable in all the tools. So based on the level of your the skill of the computer as well as technology, you can select your more comfortable devices. Apparently, you have to look on the student side also. Even if you are very good in technology, but don't impose that technology to your students. because the students are not familiar in the sense it won't be reached the students level. So that is why we are always looking at the pedagogy also. TPAC, technological pedagogical content knowledge. Your content, based on the content, you have to select the pedagogy. The pedagogy is nothing but based on the students level, based on the content level, you can find the proper pedagogy. If you find the content and pedagogy, you have to find the proper technology. In what manner we have to share the content with the pedagogy through this technology. So therefore, it may sync both. Content, technology, pedagogy, it may sync together, then only it will be good. Yeah, in the university level, it's good. In the university level, plenty of platforms are available, sir. Even I am recommending Nearpod, Google Classroom. I'm talking about the platforms, Genomia, Edmodo. So which platform you're familiar, you can go with this. Thank you all, ma'am. So happy to see. So any other questions? Yes, thank you. Dasnima, ma'am?
Shabira, ma'am, are you there?
Yes, I'm here. Okay. I'm checking whether there is any more question or not.
Okay. Over to Shabira, ma'am.
I couldn't find any more question here.
Okay, ma'am, you can wind up.
Okay. So with this, we have come to the end of our 23rd webinar. So that was a wonderful session on interactive presentation tool. Tiago sir has done a great job. He explained the things very well. So the only limitation was the time. So if we have got more time, he could explain more tools, I think. So first of all, I thank you, sir, for this very informative session. So it was the 1 hour was interactive and also very informative session. So I, on behalf of this IEEE MSS, I thank you, sir. And without the participants, this session could not be a success. So I thank all the participants for patiently listening and asking questions. So thank all of you. And there is a feedback session shared in this chat. So you can fill it. Then certificates will be mailed to your mail ID that is given in that feedback link or you have given in the registration. Thank you all once again. Thank you.
Thank you, Shabira. Thank you, Sadiq sir. Please, thank you. Thank you, Tasir, ma'am.
Thank you, Tiago sir.
Thank you. Thank you.
Sabiq sir, may I leave?
Yeah, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, sir. Bye.
Bye.